Does it smell like bacon in here?
Does it smell like bacon? I don't know. Not, maybe a little, like, a little bit.
We're down in Arizona, an Arizona hangout. Chris and Amy are actually making the trip down. They want to check it out. Where do you want to do the seating here?
I want to do it outside.
Oh, right. I forgot about that.
Now, we were going to offer them to be able to stay overnight, but they'd have to sleep in separate bedrooms. So we don't know how that would go over.
No, you said you wanted to sleep with Chris.
Oh, okay, we get the king bed?
Yes, okay. Amy and okay. I will have our separate rooms.
Chris and
you
I get
and Chris
the king.
Can watch, you know, okay. midnight shows right. together, whatever you do, I don't know.
I'm gonna offer Amy, I'm gonna have a mimosa, I think. I bought some bubbly.
Caryn went above and beyond, making sure that we have everything we need to, you know, make them as comfortable as possible and, you know, try to de-stress the any anxiety that may exist out there, you know. You know, it's funny because I go over to Amy and Chris has zero anxiety, but you know, I understand that Amy may have some anxiety coming over here. So, you know, we'll see what happens.
I'm gonna wait till they get here to pop these in because they taste better when they're heated up.
Amy and I mean, we've come a long way and Amy is very mature and I think that she is happy and she's with Chris. And her and Matt seem to be in a good place. So we want to make it nice for them. It's not like these are just some casual people coming over. We put a little more effort into it. We talked about what they would enjoy doing. You know, we're interested in continuing this relationship.
I was all calm. Now that it's like, now that we're waiting, I'm kind of antsy. I got ants in my pants.
It's actually a good round. Not very much traffic.
Yeah, and I guess we're a half a mile away.
We're here in Arizona, and we're staying with our friends Jim and Caryn, and they're a lot of fun to hang out with.
Hit me with your best shot. Missed it by a mile.
We just played pickleball, and I thought we did pretty good for the first time. Now we're gonna drive to Matt and Caryn's house and see where they live, you know, and see their place.
Well, here we go, babe. I'm gonna see my ex and his girlfriend.
Going to their place here in Arizona, you know, I will have to admit, it's not easy. It's just too much history for me.
It'll be fun.
I hope you're excited.
I am. Looking forward to it.
That's nice.
I'm hoping that Amy can see that it can be lighthearted fun to be around Matt and Caryn because that's where I'm coming from, obviously.
You don't have the history.
I don't have the history.
Right here. This is it.
I can't believe it's as easy for him to go see my ex. I just find that a little weird, frankly.
Well, thank you for indulging me. Okay, hon. Put your smiley face on. It's going to be fun.
Hey!
Hey, man!
You made it!
We made it!
You found us on the coldest day of the year.
Actually, it's kind of nice.
Oh,
to...
for you, yeah. That, no, well, if this is perfect, then... You don't want to move down.
Hi.
Hi. Welcome.
Hi,
yeah,
guys.
Thank you.
Good.
Come on in, guys. Let's show you around.
Wow, is this real or fake? Look at those leaves
on.
It is my ex. It is his girlfriend, and I don't want to pretend or put on a facade that this is happy-go-lucky and nothing has happened. You know, I just want to go in there a little cautiously, but I also want to be real as well.
Let's show you guys around real quick. This is where Zach and Tori have stayed.
Well, this is a guest room.
So it's kind of like it's a guest room. It's kind of like its own master.
We have a great relationship with Amy and Chris. It's really what I'd always hoped would happen. And, you know, in a perfect world, you know, Zach and Tori would come down to Arizona and we'd all kind of vacation together. But that's not in the cards right now.
The master's for us is the perfect size.
Oh, and yeah. It's this is really good size.
We lowered the counter.
Oh, yeah, perfect.
It's a little low for Caryn, so I don't recommend it. And then this shower here, we put the valves.
It's probably your walk-in closet.
Yeah, the walk-in closet.
Oh, and you lowered the valves. Yep. I like the tile work and everything you did.
Yeah, we did
there.
Tile, and so it's very comfortable. It's very simple.
I think being in Matt's house that, you know, they share together, Matt and Caryn, you know, it in some ways it did feel like the Twilight Zone.
Did you guys have breakfast? I got some muffins and stuff. And then are you okay sitting outside?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Let's
come on over and help yourself.
I don't think I ever will forget about the past, but I hope I can use the past to create a good norm for me moving forward, because my present and future is with this guy.
That's right.
Well, thank you very much. You didn't have to do all this.
Oh, well, I figured. I didn't know if you guys were going to have breakfast or not, so.
I just had a bowl of cereal.
I don't know if it was weird for Amy. I suppose there's a small component that might be awkward, but we're all adults, and I think curiosity about even my ex-husband, it comes up. I would want to know what he's doing and what he's up to because I have a relationship with him. And so I thought it was actually normal.
So what's a typical week like for you guys down here?
I usually come right straight out here.
Well, you sleep in. I get up early.
Yeah, I sleep in. And then she goes and visits her folks or goes shopping. We see her folks like twice a day. She goes there once in the morning, and then they come and hang out right here.
No.
Where do they live?
About a mile and a half from here. Mm. They're in the community. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And our biggest decision every day, are we going to Cimarron or Adobe? It's because there's the two. I like one better. He likes the other one better.
The farm, after all these 30 years, you know, gets old and it gets tiresome, and I'm getting older, 60, and I was really, you know, it's a lot of work. When I go to Arizona, this is, you know, my relaxed time, my refuge. It's good for the longevity of my heartbeat.
Are you guys kind of starting to think about retirement or how you want to do your future?
I think, we figure it'll probably be, another 5 years, I think.
No, I think what we're looking at is, because I definitely cannot retire yet, or we can't retire yet, but in a couple of years, where we're living right now is not the forever home, no. But we'll probably look in about another couple of years, because it's probably going to take a year or more to figure out where we want to be.
You're talking about Oregon, or are you talking?
Northwest.
Got it.
Yeah.
We
want to stay in the Northwest. We're all on the same page on that.
We're just beginning to talk about it and think about what does that look like. We don't have really any set plans.
Yeah, we're not quite retired yet, but it's both of our goals to travel more and see the world. But, you know, it's still a few years down the road, so it's hard to make those plans now. It's just too far in the future.
I think for us, we were thinking about, you know, wherever that place may be that we kind of settle down as our home base, because I always look at a home base as if I have no money, I like where I'm at.
Yeah.
If I have a lot of money, I still like where I'm at. Right. And so I think that's what we're kind of looking at.
Well, cheers, guys. Welcome.
Well, cheers.
Yeah, well, thank you for the invite.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, thanks again for the tickets and the invite down here.
I thought the brunch went great with Amy Critz, and hoping the rest of the trip goes just as smoothly.